we are the roots and shoots of a living world. Roots and shoots everywhere. The hopes and dreams of a living world. We dig the earth and we reach for the sky.
Roots and shoots, roots and shoots.
We root so low and we shoot
Shanghai
so
roots
high.
Roots and Shoots program is part of a global network of localized nonprofit organizations that promote active civil society in over 120 countries worldwide. Established in 1999, Shanghai Roots and Shoots program encourages youth to be advocates for environmental and wildlife protection, as well as poverty alleviation and social initiatives by giving them the tools and support to carry out projects of their own design.
The hopes and dreams of a living world. We are the seeds and we are the buds. Grow through the concrete, grow through the walls.
Roots and shoots, roots and shoots.
The power of life.
Hi, my name is Phoebe, and I'm a Roots and Shoots representative.
Hi, Phoebe.
Hi.
Would you like to tell us a little bit about Roots and Shoots and why you joined?
I joined Roots and Shoots because I love helping the earth, and I've had a lot of experience planting, and it's one of my hobbies, and I really like the idea of helping and making a change in our planet Earth.
And what was your favorite activity this year in Roots and Shoots?
My favorite activity in Roots and Shoots, I would probably have to say, was making the books and also planting. I thought it was really fun to get scrap paper and use that in a creative way and make something spectacular that you can use and recycle.
Excellent. And how did you encourage others to buy trees for the Million Tree Project?
Well, you know, it wouldn't be that great if you went around begging people to buy trees, but I thought that the best way would probably be advertising or talking to them about why we do it and helping them, you know, think what's the best idea. And I also taped place and I'm in the middle of making a website, and I think whoever looks at that will also think, oh yeah, I should make some trees.
Excellent. What message would you give to others who are wondering what they can do to support the Million Tree Project and Mother Earth?
I would probably say that if you want to make a change, plant, throw your rubbish in the bin, don't just leave it on the floor, don't litter, and don't do anything bad to nature, probably.
Thank you, Phoebe, for sharing. Hi, Simon.
Hi.
I understand that your father's company donated 100 trees. Do you want to tell us about that?
Well, my dad, also likes, the environment. He also cares, so, we asked him polite to, ask his company if he can, donate trees so we can, reach our goal. And our goal is 1,000 trees. So my dad did a very good job.
We are here today with Antoine and Inchuan from P2 Red. Would you like to share with us what you have done for Roots and Shoots as class representatives this year? Inchuan?
So in P2, we should not play video games, just play outside. Off the lights and turn off the water when you're not using it, and pick up rubbish and throw it in the recycle bin or rubbish bin.
All right. And Antoine, what did you do for Roots and Shoots this year?
I helped planted the plants and the trees and the vegetables and all sorts of plants.
What was your favorite activity in Roots and Shoots this year?
I think it was digging and returning over the soil.
Ah, that was very fun. Do either of you have a message to the audience as to what they can do to help the environment or Mother Earth?
You can pick up rubbish, put it in a bin, but not just for Earth Day, for every day.
Awesome. Intuin, any message?
Well, turn off the lights, turn off the water, and take short showers. Uh-huh. If you have any drinking water left, you can put it for the plants.
Awesome. Good idea. Thank you both for sharing today. Sophia, would you tell us why you joined Roots and Shoots?
Well, when I was in P3, Roots and Shoots wasn't really at the school yet, and I learned about rainforests, and I learned that many rainforests are being cut down, and I was really sad about that, and I wanted to do something to help, but I didn't know what. Then in P4, Roots and Shoots came to this school, and I wanted to join because I was thinking, wow, this is an awesome opportunity to help Mother Earth. So I joined Roots and Shoots.
Excellent. What kinds of action have you taken this year with Roots and Shoots?
This year for the fun day, my friends and I, we decided we would want to make jewelry to sell to raise money for Roots and Shoots. I've helped garden, and I brought some cookies I made for the bake sale we had, and I've been supporting. I have Roots and Shoots t-shirts, bags. I use my Roots and Shoots knapsack for library books, and I really tried to help.
You certainly sound like you do. Sophia, do you have a message to those listening about how they can help Mother Earth?
Just remember that life is like a web, and if one strand is broken, everything else goes crazy. So just keep in mind that you're a part of this huge web, and that you need to care for Mother Earth, which is one strand.
Excellent message. Thank you, Sophia.
Roots and shoots, roots and shoots.
We root so low and we shoot so high.
Roots and shoots, roots and shoots.
We love the birds and we love the trees.
Roots and shoots, roots and shoots.
We love the whales and the chimpanzees. Roots and shoots, we are the roots and shoots of a living world. Roots and shoots everywhere, the hopes and dreams of a living world.
Hi, I'm Maddie.
Hi, I'm Chan.
Zichan and I are the members of the MTP delegation team. Yuli has committed in planting 2 forests, each 1,000 trees. Together with other schools and companies, 210,000 trees have been planted this April. Since 2007, 820,000 trees have been planted. On behalf of the Roots and Shoots Club, we would love to share our year-long journey and complete our goal of MTP program.
About the food here in Inner Mongolia. What was your favorite so far?
It's like sweet corn with cut cucumbers in pieces, and it's really sweet that not everyone would like it.
Zichen.
Yes.
You have definitely found a few things you've liked up here. You want to tell us about it?
Yeah. I find a kind of fried rice with beef, especially they got many beefs here.
Yes.
So I think it's quite good. I mean, the meal here, it's quite like the Canton meal. What is it? Sam, how can I say? I like it. I like the meal here. Yeah, actually.
What about the drinks?
The almond milk.
Oh, I'm not going to talk about the milk.
The milk?
It's terrible.
So, the chat, tell us why you chose to come to Inner Mongolia.
I want more experience about what it real likes in the north of China. And especially Mongolia, it's a special place for me to know about. I want to see about the desert. How is it going now?
And what is your first impressions when you came here?
It's a quite beautiful place, especially like the sky. So you can see it's clean and blue, but you can still find the problems about the deserts, and you can see the sands on the ground. It not match. Like you can see a clean and blue sky, but you can't see green with it. So strange.
Expectations was either finding birds or insects, anything that was living and not dead this year.
Maddie, what changes did you see this year over last year?
I saw that there was a little bit of wildlife this year than last year, because last year was just dead, nothing, and it was like just quiet. And this year you could hear a lot of chirping from magpies, and you could see beetles and little insects. And there are also holes that was at like the sand little hills. And it wasn't probably spider holes, because spider holes are deeper.
Is this your first trip?
Yeah, first trip to be here. Ah. And you cannot imagine, the countryside view is so nature, so good. Just like I saw them at the cinema. The blue sky, you cannot find that kind of blue sky in Shanghai. Yeah.
Nor can you find the stars we saw the other night.
Yeah.
They were amazing. Awesome. What made you choose to come to Inner Mongolia?
Charity.
Charity, okay.
Yeah. It's our corporate social responsibility to contribute your contribution to plant the trees.
Right. How many trees did your company raise?
360 yesterday. Mm. We have eight staffs together to plant 360 trees. And today we cut almost, I think, 30 trees. Meaningful for us to spend 2 days here. Not only the view, but also the charity staff.
Yeah. And what company do you represent?
Bacardi.
This is an international school, so students are from all around the world.
Yeah, they'll know it.
You're not allowed to drink before the legal drinking age.
I think they'll know.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. In the desert, pruning trees. So what did you think about this morning's desert walk?
Wow, that's terrible. Kind of like a hell. So that's why I'm doing this. Let the trees go strong.
So what was your biggest impression of the desert walk in the sand dunes?
Plant more trees. Yeah, the most thing I thought in that time, and there's a sandstone, and just what I think in this stone, it's like, oh, I should plant more trees.
That was quite a sandstorm, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's crazy.
Thank you, Zichen.
那么这个树林到现在已经像这批的话应该可能是08年的，再往前，
说的是他们可以用来烧火，
其实这些都是理由。第一个是要有顶个主干的优势，是不是？就是通过修枝肉把一些旁枝侧枝修掉，这样它主干名是主干的优势非常明显，它这个树就很容易往上涨，形成一个非常大的一个主干，这样这个木材才能成材，不然的话它就会变成很多细小的枝条。
Hello, I'm Chen Chen. I'm director of MTP.
This is Wendy.
I'm Wendy. I'm the leader of this trip.
How long have you guys actually been in shoots?
No more than 1 year, but I was working as a volunteer for like almost 3 years.
Yeah, a longer history with as volunteer to Roots and Shoots.
Did you accomplish your goals in Roots and Shoots?
Even more than I expected. Well, I have to be honest.
Are you happy to actually finish Roots and Vermilion Tree Project next year?
Hopefully.
Yeah, with all your support, thank you. Thank you, Deloitte.
And if you actually finish a million tree projects, what would you do next?
Second million. Second million, of course.
The Million Tree Project in Inner Mongolia, trying to change the desert into some kind of life so that people can have better lives and a greater future in Mongolia. And a last message to everybody, if you would just spend a few minutes every day thinking about the consequences of the small choices you make, what you buy, what you eat, what you wear, and make tiny adjustments in your lifestyle as a result of that, this is gradually going to lead to the change around the world that we must see if we truly care about the future for our children and our grandchildren.
Roots and shoots, we are the roots and shoots of a living world.